गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द क्लास फॉर सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड साइंस सब्जेक्ट एंड फिजिक्स अवतार लेसन इज फोर्स एंड मोशन. ओके, इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ फोर्स एज वेल एज द टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्स, दैट इज कॉन्टैक्ट एंड नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेस एंड द एजेंसीज ऑफ फोर्सेस, दैट इज एनिमेट एजेंसी एंड इनएनिमेट एजेंसी. ओके, सो टू कंटिन्यू दैट लेसन नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन. ओके, सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट वन इज लीनियर मोशन. ओके, सो लीनियर मीन्स it refers to the straight line. Okay, linear means it refers to the straight line. Okay, anything that has to be traveled in a straight line. Okay, so moving in a straight line, example like a person walking on a straight path due to the free fall motion. Okay, so this is referred to as the linear motion. Motion means a movement. Okay, moving condition that is taken along the straight line. Okay, so that is known as the linear motion. Then the next one is curvilinear motion. Okay, so curvilinear motion means motion refers to the movement and curvilinear refers to the half of the circle. Okay, half of the circle like throwing ball, no? Okay, so half of the circle of the motion is known as the curvilinear motion, moving ahead but changing direction. Okay, so here it's a move along a path. Okay, so it's starting from one direction and ending in another direction. Okay, so there is a change in the direction. Okay, so then only it's known as the curvilinear motion. For example, like a throwing ball. Okay, then the third type of motion is circular motion. Okay, circular, you know, it's a circle shape. Okay, so the motion is taken along the circular path. Okay, that is known as the circular motion, moving in a circle. Example, swirling stone tied to the rope. Okay, that is the stone is tied with the end of the rope and rotating a circle direction. Okay, then the fourth type of motion is rotatory motion. Okay, so this is like a circular motion, the movement of a body about its own axis. Okay, the movement of your body about its own axis. Okay, so that is known as the rotatory motion, like a rotating of top. Okay, pampara sutula andadu. Okay, so like a rotating of top. Then the fifth one is oscillatory motion. Okay, so the motion is taken along the oscillatory shape, that is like a pendulum clock. Okay, or in a spring back and forth movement. Okay, or in the case of a simple pendulum means or pendulum clock means left and right direction. Okay, the motion is taken along the left from right or front and both front and back direction. Okay, so coming back to the same position after a time interval. Okay, after a some time interval it comes back to the original position, like a pendulum clock. Okay, example is a pendulum clock. Then the last motion, the last type of motion is zigzag motion. Okay, so the zigzag motion means there is no any direction. Okay, we can't indicate any direction of the motion. Okay, like the motion of a bee. Okay, that is in Tamil called it as theni. Okay, so like a motion of a bee or the people walking in a crowded street. Okay, people walking in a crowded street means we can't indicate or we can't able to identify the direction of the people that are walking in a crowded street. Okay, so these are the different types of motion. So these are the different types of motion. Okay, first one is along a straight line, so it refers to as a linear motion. And then the second one is a half of the circle. Okay, so half of the circle is referred to as a circular motion. Okay, like a throwing ball. Then the third one is a circular motion. Okay, so it rotating along a circular shape. Okay, so that is referred to as a circular motion. And the fourth one is zigzag motion. Okay, there is no any direction. Okay, we can't identify any direction. Okay, so this is referred to as a zigzag motion. And the last one is oscillatory motion, like a swing. Okay, left and right motion or back and forth movement. Okay, so these are the different types of motion. Next type of motion is what means periodic motion. Okay, this is according with the time interval. Okay, that's why this is called as the periodic motion. Okay, so take the case of the hover hand of a clock. Okay, so in the case of a clock there is two two needle. Okay, sorry, three needle. One is for second, another one is for a minute, and the next one is for hour. Okay, so take that case. In one day, it makes two rounds. Okay, so in one day, the clock makes two rounds. That is for 12 hours. Okay, so 24 hours, two rounds. Looking at a bouncing ball, it bounces a certain number of times for a given time interval or period. Okay, so example, in the case of a, we can take the case of a bouncing ball means it bounces a certain number of times. Okay, for during that particular time, it bounces the certain number. Okay, for example, 5 times and 6 times. After some time, it will comes to the rest position. Okay, that bouncing ball will comes to the rest position. Okay, so the motion repeated in equal intervals of time. Okay, motion that is repeated in equal intervals of time means that motion is referred to as a periodic motion. Okay, equal interval of time. Okay, the motion is taken along the equal interval of time means that is referred to as a periodic motion. For example, revolution of the moon around the earth. Okay, so that is referred to as the periodic motion, but not oscillatory motion. Okay, so this is only referred as a periodic motion. That is, which one? The revolution of the moon around the earth. Okay, is referred to as a periodic motion, but not oscillatory motion. Then the second one is the children playing in a swing. Okay, so there is a back and forth movement. Okay, so it is referred to as a periodic motion as well as the oscillatory motion. Okay, so the children playing in a swing is referred to as a both periodic motion as well as the oscillatory motion. Okay, so the next one is non-periodic motion. Okay, so non-periodic means here the time interval is changed. Okay, unequal time interval. Okay, so the motion is not in uniform interval. That means there is a some change in time interval. Okay, so that's why this is referred to as the non-periodic motion. Okay, students, thank you.